Yes, very good morning to students. I'm audible to all and the screen is visible to everyone. Yes, student, I'm audible to all and the screen is visible to everyone. Please give the reply
Yes,
in the chat box. Okay. So in today's lecture, we are seeing about the different types of the resistance setting, right? So in the previous lecture, we are seeing about the direct resistance setting. In this lecture, we will see about the indirect resistance setting. So what do you mean by indirect resistance setting? So if we're going to start this new topic in today's lecture, we are just focused which we have to see in the previous lecture, right? So in the previous lecture, we are just discussing about the resistance hitting, sorry, direct resistance hitting, as well as what are the basic difference between the power frequency hitting as well as the high frequency hitting, right? So power frequency hitting means what? Whenever we are just transferring the heat from one part of substance to another part of substances by using the different types of the modes of the heat transfer, by that it will be the radiation, it will be the conduction, it will be the convection mode of heat transfer. So it is known as a power frequency heating, right? So whenever we are just see about the high frequency heating, so in case of the high frequency heating, we can just transfer the heat by using the electromagnetic energy into the another type, which in this material the heat is produces within itself. So this is known as the high frequency heating, right? So these are the basic difference between the power frequency as well as the high frequency heating. So whenever we are just discussing about the direct resistance setting, so in direct resistance setting, we are just taking the example of bath furnace, right? Again, one more example we are taking whenever we are see about the direct resistance setting. So in case of the direct resistance setting, we are just see the one diagram here. I think those students are not present in the previous lecture, so please see here. I just explain again one more time. So here we are just taking one furnace. Yes. So into this furnace, I just immerse the two electrodes. That is, these two electrodes. So for this two electrode, I just sending the supply. That is giving the supply. So this supply is also giving to this electrode, which will be immersed into the charges. Right. So charges, मतलब क्या है? So charges, it will be, it is in the form of some pieces, some powder. Right. So now, when we are giving the supply, the supply will be the single phase AC or single or three phase AC. ठीक है? So whenever we are using the single phase, so in that case we are just using the two electrode, and whenever we are just using the three phase, so in that case we are just using or we are just taking the three electrode here, right? So this resistance heating will be work on the I square R losses, right? That means heat will be produces when this heat is proportional to I square R loss, right? I square R means what? Which material we are using for the for producing the heat, right? For developing the heat into this particular material itself. So this material is having the resistive property. And whenever we are just sending the voltage or giving the supply to this resistive material, so due to this resistive property, it can just flowing the current into this material, and whenever this current is insufficient to develop the temperature, sufficient to develop the heat, and then the heat will be produces, right? It is a resistance heating only. So in case of the direct resistance setting, what will be happening here? Whenever we are just giving the supply to this electrode, then this electrode will be produces the heat within itself, and this heat will be transferred by using the different methods of the conduction, convection, and radiation to these charges. And these charges, it is in the form of pieces, some powder, and these charges will be made, right? These charges will be get this heat by using the different modes of heat transfer, and it can just heat up, and this is known as a direct resistance setting. Yes, I think this concept is very very simple, and it is understood to all the students, right? So this is all about the direct resistance setting. So the base example of this direct resistance setting is a bath furnace. So soiled bath furnace, right? Now, my voice is clear, right? My voice is clear. Okay, 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 fine. ठीक है. सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर सी अबाउट द इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग, राइट? सो बेसिकली दिस इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग इज वेरी मच सिमिलर टू द डायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग. ओनली इज डिफरेंस दैट इन केस ऑफ द डायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस हीटिंग वी आर जस्ट यूजिंग द इलेक्ट्रोड फॉर producing the heat itself, and then we are just transferring this heat which is produced by using the electrode. This heat will be transferred by using the different modes of the heat transfer to the charges for producing the heat in charge itself, right? So but in case of the indirect resistance heating, we are just using the coil, yes, wire, heating element. तो जो भी हम लोग यहाँ पे हीटिंग एलिमेंट यूज कर रहे हैं इन केस ऑफ द इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस हीटिंग, सो इट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ दिस वायर, इट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सम कॉइल फॉर्म, राइट? सो हाउ इट इज ऑपरेटेड, सो जस्ट फर्स्ट वी आर जस्ट टेकिंग हियर द वन सिलेंड्रिकल वेसल, दैट इज सिलेंडर. सो इन टू दिस सिलेंडर वी आर जस्ट फिल्ड सम charges, and this charges, it is in the form of pieces and some powder, right? So again, in this cylinder we are just taking one jacket, and into this jacket we are just taking these charges, and into this jacket we again immerse one heating element, right? So this heating element, and this heating element, it will be the some coil, resistive coil, it will be the some wire, right? So we can just immerse this heating element into this jacket, which is enclosed into one cylinder, and this jacket is also whenever we are just immerse some heating element into this charges, right? Now here were two inputs are see here, that is for supply purpose. So by using this two supply ports, we are just giving the supply to this electrode or to this wire, right? So now how this indirect resistance heating will be operated, we are just see here. So in this method of heating, the electric current is passed through a wire or other high resistive material forming a heating element, right? जैसे कि हमने अभी कहा कि यहाँ पे हम जो भी supply provide करते हैं to these heating elements, so the current will be flowing into this wire. यहाँ पे एक wire भी हो सकता है, या हम उसको बोल सकते हैं it is the high resistive material which is forming a heating element. Right? Now, the heat proportional to the I square R losses which produces in the heating element and is delivered to the charge by one or more methods of the heat of transfer. It may be the conduction, it may be the convection, and it may be the radiation. Right? So if the heat is transferred by conduction, the resistor must be in the contact with the charges, right? And enclosed there and known as a heating chamber is required for heat transfer by radiation and convection for the element, which will be kept in cylindrical surrounded by jacket containing the charges. So what will be happening here in case of the indirect resistance heating, what will be happening whenever we are just giving the supply to this? Yes, whenever we are just giving the supply to this wire, yes, यहाँ पे दिख रहा है, आपको डायग्राम दिख रहा है, यहाँ पे आपको आपके जो तीनों ये है, तीनों मोड ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर है, इट विल बी वर्किंग एट द सेम टाइम. हाउ इट इज वर्क, यहाँ पे देखो एक आपको सिलेंडर दिख रहा है, तो सिलेंडर के जो बाहर का साइड है वहां पे हमने क्या किया है, एक वहां पे एक जैकेट है, राइट? सो जैकेट में हमने क्या किया, जैकेट में आपने जो चार्जेस है वो चार्जेस को पुल किया है, राइट? जैकेट में जो आपके चार्जेस है उसको मुझे नहीं करना है, उसको मुझे हीट अप करना है बाय यूजिंग व्हाट, बाय यूजिंग दिस सप्लाई व्हिच इज गिवन टू दिस हीटिंग एलिमेंट। जैसे ये चार्ज हीटअप हो जाते हैं, सो बाय यूजिंग दिस विच मेथड, इट इज अ कंडक्शन मेथड। मतलब यहाँ पे जो भी आपके वायर है, यहाँ पे जो कॉइल है, व्हेन इट इज अ रेजिस्टिव मटेरियल, सो व्हेन इट कैन जस्ट टेकिंग दिस अप्लाई, इट कैन जस्ट प्रोड्यूसेस अ हीट विद इन इटसेल्फ, राइट? एंड दिस हीट इज ट्रांसफर टू दिस चार्जेस बाय यूजिंग द कंडक्शन मेथड, राइट? सो कंडक्शन मेथड, राइट? तो कंडक्शन मेथड से अगर इसको हम लोग हीट करते हैं तो उसके बाद में हमको क्या करना है कि विच जो भी हीट यहाँ पे प्रोड्यूस हुई है विद इन चार्ज है, तो वो हीट को मुझे अगर ट्रांसफर करना है, सो इन दैट केस अब आउट ऑफ दिस सिलेंडर, राइट? बिकॉज जो भी आपका एक अरेंजमेंट है किसमें किया हमने, सिलेंडर में किया है, वन वी आर हैविंग वन सिलेंडर, एंड इन टू दिस सिलेंडर वन जैकेट वी आर जस्ट प्रोवाइडिंग यू, एंड इन टू दिस जैकेट वी आर जस्ट इमर्स सम चार्जेस, राइट? सो अगर वो चार्ज हिटअप हो जाते हैं, तो अगर उसको मुझे वो हीट को मुझे ट्रांसफर करना है, तो इन दैट केस वी आर जस्ट यूजिंग हियर द अनादर टू मेथड ऑफ द मोड्स ऑफ द हीट ट्रांसफर, एंड दिस विल बी द रेडिएशन हीटिंग एज वेल एज द कन्वेक्शन हीटिंग। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस हीटिंग। नाउ वॉट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ दिस इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस हीटिंग? यस, एनीवन प्लीज? यस मनीषा, यस मनीषा, व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस, यस व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस हीटिंग एज कंपेयर टू द डायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस हीटिंग? यस बेटा, ओके, डोंट नो, ओके। सो एडवांटेजेस ऑफ दिस इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस हीटिंग इज नथिंग बट द दिस अरेंजमेंट प्रोवाइड यूनिफॉर्म टेम्परेचर अराउंड दिस होल प्रोसीजर, सो वेन एवर वी कैन जस्ट प्रोवाइडिंग द control to this process, so we can just provide the automatic temperature control can be provided in case of the indirect resistance setting. Now in case of this indirect resistance setting, one more advantages, so these advantages is nothing but what we are just taking here, the both AC as well as DC supply can be used for this purpose. Okay, again, what are the examples of this indirect resistance setting? Yes, what are the examples, what are the applications of this? Examples of this heating, indirect resistance heating? Yes. Yes, koi bhi bata sakte ho? What are the applications? Yes, Yogesh.
मैम डिफरेंस बताना है क्या?
नहीं नहीं एप्लीकेशन बेटा, एप्लीकेशन, व्हाट आर द एप्लीकेशन, व्हाट आर द यूजेस ऑफ दिस इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग, हम लोग कहाँ पे यूज करते हैं इसको? कहाँ पे यूज करते बेटा ये? यस एनीवन? ओके, देखो क्या होता है कि ये आप यहाँ पे हम लोग क्या करते हैं कि इन दैट केस विद इन द इन केस ऑफ द इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग वी आर जस्ट यूजिंग द हाईली रेजिस्टिव एलिमेंट, राइट? सो दिस रेजिस्टिव एलिमेंट इट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वायर भी रह सकता है, कॉइल भी रह सकता है, सो व्हेनेवर वी आर जस्ट गिविंग द सप्लाई टू दिस कॉइल, देन विद इन इट्स कॉइल द हीट विल बी प्रोड्यूसेस, एंड देन हीट विल बी transfer by using the conduction method to the charges, and the charges will be also heat up, right? Now, whenever these charges will be heat up, heat will be produced within its charges, and heat will be transferred to this cylindrical chamber, right? So by using which method? By using the another two types of the modes of the heat transfer method. This method will be the radiation, and this method again will be the convection method. So what are the examples of this indirect resistance heating? Yes, where we are applying this method in domestic purpose. Yes.
Ovens.
Yes, iron, then room heater and water heater. Yes, beta. Yes. कौन बता रहा था अभी
मैम? वाटर हीटर सेम स्ट्रक्चर रहते हैं मैम.
यस, इट इज अ वाटर हीटर. जो हम लोग घर पे वाटर हीटर यूज करते हैं, सो व्हेन वी आर जस्ट टेकिंग वन कॉइल इनटू द बकेट व्हिच इनटू दिस वाटर व्हिच विल बी इमर्स्ड, सो व्हेन वी आर जस्ट गिविंग द सप्लाई एंड ऑल्सो वी आर जस्ट यूजिंग द हाई रेजिस्टिव दिस रेजिस्टिव कॉइल, राइट? एंड अगेन वन मोर इमर्शन वाटर हीटर. इमर्शन वाटर हीटर मतलब क्या है कि जो हम लोग कॉइल यूज करते हैं घर पे वाटर को हीट करने के लिए, ठीक है? सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग. सो आई थिंक यू हैव टू, यू ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट व्हाट आर द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग एज वेल एज इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग. सो व्हाट आर द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग एज वेल एज इनडायरेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस सेटिंग? यस, एनीवन? What are the main difference between the direct resistance heating as well as indirect resistance heating?
Mode of heating element, ma'am.
Yes, it is a mode of heating element. Yes. Again, second. Yes. This is very correct. The mode of heating element. Is anyone? Ankita Dambhare. What are the basic difference between the direct resistance heating and indirect resistance heating according to different applications? Yes, Ankita.
Yes, ma'am.
On the basis of supply.
Supply, yes. According to supply, we bol sakte. Because in case of the direct resistance heating, we are just using the AC supply. In case of the indirect resistance heating, we are just taking the both supply, that is AC as well as DC. Right? Okay. Next one. Yes. Again, or kaun sa difference bata sakte hai according to which application? Which?
Ma'am, temperature ke baare mein.
Yes, temperature controlling. Right? So in case of the direct resistance heating, we cannot provide automatic temperature control. But in case of the indirect resistance heating, we are just providing the automatic temperature control can be provided. Okay. Again, next, जैसे कि हमने one more difference is that जैसे कि हमने in case of the direct resistance heating में we are just taking one vessel, right? So into this vessel, we are just transferring the heat only by using the one method to the one substances. That means we are just taking the directly, we can just transfer the heat. But in this case, indirect resistance setting, we are just having one jacket, we are just having one cylinder, right? So this one is also the one difference between this direct resistance setting and indirect resistance setting. Okay? So I think this this two type of the direct resistance setting and indirect resistance setting is very much clear to all the students. Yes, can we start the next? Yes, so next topic is arc heating. Yes. So whenever we are see about the classifications of electrical heating, so in that electrical heating, we have to see first one is electrical heating is classified into the two types. That is, the first one is the power frequency heating and the second one is the high frequency heating, right? So Now similarly, we are just again classified into this power frequency to heating into these two types. That is, first one is the resistance heating, and the second one is the arc heating. Yes, this one. Yes, all of you see this diagram. The classifications of electrical heating. Yes, this slide is visible to everyone. The classifications of electrical heating. Okay, so I think in the previous lecture I already discussing about this electrical heating. So in this lecture we are seeing about this arc heating. So whenever we are just classified the power frequency heating into different two types, that is the resistance heating as well as arc heating. So similarly, in case of the arc heating, we are again classified into two types, that is direct arc heating as well as the indirect arc heating, right? So whenever we are see this arc heating, so which material we are using for this arc heating? So we are just see here. Yes. So arc heating मतलब क्या होता है? So heating of matter by an electric arc, the matter which may be the solid, liquid or gases. So when the heating is direct, the material to be heated is one electrode. Or when the for heating is indirect heating, the heat is transferred from the arc by convection or the radiation method. So what are the difference between this resistance heating and arc heating? So whenever we are just giving the supply to this electrode, so or to this some material which will be used for this arc production, so whenever we are just transferring the heat from one electrode to another electrode, so this will be the, it is in the form of arc, and this arc will be transfer the energy, transfer the heat in the form of arc by using the different methods. So this method will be the convection method or radiation method. ठीक है? So arc मतलब क्या होता है कि जैसे कि अगर आपके पास दो इलेक्ट्रोड है, दो इलेक्ट्रोड को अगर हम लोग सप्लाई प्रोवाइड करते हैं, so this electrode will be generated the heat, generated the energy, generated temperature within itself. ठीक है? वो जो एनर्जी जनरेट हुई है उसको मुझे ट्रांसफर करना है टू दी अनदर पार्ट ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस, राइट? सो दिस एनर्जी विल बी ट्रांसफर टू दी अनदर पार्ट ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस बाय यूजिंग द आर्क, बाय फॉर्मिंग द आर्क, राइट? सो दिस आर्क विल बी फॉर्म बाय यूजिंग द डिफरेंट मोड्स ऑफ द हीट ट्रांसफर, एंड दिस मोड ऑफ द हीट ट्रांसफर विल बी द convection method as well as the radiation method. ठीक है? What do you mean by arc heating? Arc heating is how it can just conduct it. So we are using the electrode. हमारे पास में electrode रहेंगे. अगर direct resistance heating है तो direct heating है तो in case of the direct heating we are just using the one electrode, right? So whenever we are just giving the supply to this electrode, then this electrode will be generated the heat within itself, and this heat will be transferred to the another part of the substances, another part of the material by using the arc form, right? So how this arc will be produced? This all this method, all this methods we are just see in the whenever we are just see the types of this arc heating. So now this arc is formed or arc is produced by using the two methods, that is the mode of the heat transfer. मतलब हमें क्या करना है कि जो भी हीट आपकी प्रोड्यूस हो रही है वो within this electrode and this electrode का जो हीट हमको ट्रांसफर करना है arc के फॉर्म में, and this arc के फॉर्म में जो भी ट्रांसफर हो रही है वो by using the दो मोड ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर से होगी. It will be the convection रह सकता है और it will be the radiation भी हो सकता है, right? Now, so now the next one topic is this, जो हम लोग यहाँ पे arc heating देखने वाले हैं. So this arc heating में जो हम लोग electrodes use कर वाले हैं, the arc में right?
में आवाज ब्रेक हो रहा है।
आता बस आता ये तो क्लियर, आता क्लियर है तो बेटा।
यस मैम।
यस नाउ इट ओके। ठीक है, तो अभी हमको देखना है कि विच मटेरियल वी आर जस्ट प्रेफर्ड फॉर द इलेक्ट्रोड विच विल बी यूज इन द आर्क फर्नेस। देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ द मटेरियल विच विल बी यूज फॉर द इलेक्ट्रोड, दैट इज फर्स्ट वन इज द कार्बन इलेक्ट्रोड, then graphite electrode and the third one is a cell baking electrode. So whenever we are using this carbon electrode, so what are the basic features of this carbon electrode we are just see here. Okay, so jo bhi hum log carbon electrode use karte hain, so it is made up of anthracite coal and the coal, right? So jo hum log carbon electrode use karne wale hain, so this carbon electrode which will be the made up of the coal, anthracite coal. So anthracite coal मतलब क्या? It is one type of the I think like coal type है, ठीक है? And the coke. So again it is cheaper. उसके बाद में uniform heating रहती है. So uniform heating can be obtained with a large area of carbon electrode. उसके बाद में उसका जो भी oxidation रहता है, जैसे कि हमको ऑक्सीडेशन बोलते हैं हम लोग, सो ऑक्सीडेशन स्टार्ट एट अबाउट द 600 डिग्री सेल्सियस। आई थिंक दिस ऑल द पॉइंट्स प्लीज ऑल यू स्टूडेंट राइट डाउन इन योर कॉपी, ठीक है? व्हेनेवर आई एम गिविंग अनदर पॉइंट्स विच इज नॉट प्रेजेंट इन योर स्लाइड, सो प्लीज ऑल यू स्टूडेंट इट राइट डाउन इन योर कॉपी। So whenever we are just giving the exams or whenever we are just giving the MCQs, so on these MCQs which will be based on this, right? So which material we are just using for this arc heating? So this arc heating that is a material, that is first one is the carbon electrode. This carbon electrode which will be made up of the anthracite coal as well as coke, and also it is a very cheaper. And whenever we are just see to the oxidation, so oxidation the starts at about the 600 degree Celsius, and this carbon electrode we are uses in very small furnaces, right? So where we are using this carbon electrode? So whenever we are manufacturing that is a ferroalloys, aluminium, calcium, then phosphorus, so in that case we are just using this carbon electrode. Yes, next one is the graphite electrode. So what are the basic features of this graphite electrodes? So they are obtained by heating carbon electrode to a very high temperature. जैसे कि हम लोग कार्बन को अगर हीट करते हैं at a very high temperature, so in that case we are just obtaining this graphite electrode. That means this graphite electrode we can just achieve by heating the carbon electrode at very high temperature. So in that case we are just receive this graphite electrode. Now next one is the less amount of graphite, about 1/4 of the carbon is required for the same current heating. And again the same features of this graphite electrode, the oxidation start is at about the 600 degree Celsius. And next one is a cell baking. So what do you mean by cell baking electrode? Yes, anyone is listening this cell baking electrode? Yes. Yes, Devanand Pitkar, what is meant by cell baking electrode? Okay, so they are made up of the special paste. The composition of the paste depend on the type of process for which it employs. जैसे कि आपका cell baking electrode होता है, so cell baking electrode हम लोग जब बनाते हैं, जो आपके industries में जब it will be the made. So in that case they are using the very special paste for making this cell baking electrode, and the composition of this paste which will be depend on the type of process for एम्प्लॉय मतलब एक कौन से चीज के लिए यूज करने वाले हैं, सो उसके ऊपर उसका कंपोजिशन डिपेंड होता है, राइट। सो नाउ व्हेन वी आर जस्ट टेकिंग द सेल्फ ब्रेकिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन, सो व्हेन वी आर जस्ट गिविंग द सप्लाई टू दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन, राइट, फॉर प्रोड्यूसिंग और फॉर ट्रांसफरिंग द हीट इक्विटी व्हिच इट इज इनटू द पार्ट, इट इज इनटू द वे ऑफ द आर्क। सो व्हेन इन दिस वे द करंट इज पास, राइट, एंड हीट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड दैट बेक्स द पेस्ट टू फॉर्म इलेक्ट्रोड। तो यहाँ पे जो सेल्फ बेकिंग इलेक्ट्रोड होता है वो कैसे प्रिपेयर होता है, वो कैसे बनता है, सो क्या होता है वहां पे कि वी आर जस्ट गिविंग द सप्लाई टू दिस पेस्ट, राइट, सो हीट इज प्रोड्यूस एंड दैट बेक्स द पेस्ट टू फॉर्म इलेक्ट्रोड। जो पेस्ट रहती है वो पेस्ट क्या हो जाती है, बेक हो जाती है ड्यू टू द हीट, एंड देन बाय यूजिंग दिस पेस्ट we can just produce this, we can just making the electrode, that is a self baking electrode, right. Again this self baking electrode we also use to production of the ferroalloys, electrochemical furnace and in production of aluminium by electrolyte process. Yes, it is a self baking electrode. So self baking electrode kaise banta hai, so it is a very special type of the electrode. So it can just use in the special paste. How this composition will be done of this cell baking electrode? So whenever we are just giving the current, whenever it is giving the supply, so current is flowing into this particular material. So in this heat will be produced, and due to this heat, it can just bake the paste, and due to this baking this paste, the electrode will be formed. So now this cell baking electrode we also use for the production of the ferroalloys, electrochemical furnace and in production of aluminium by electrolyte process. Yes? Okay. So this is the three types of the electrode used in the arc furnaces. That is, first one is the carbon, graphite and the cell baking electrode. I think it is clear to all the students. Yes, please write down in the one in your book. We are just having the three types of the electrode material, that is the carbon, graphite and the cell baking. Okay. So the next one is the types of the arc heating furnace. So basically, whenever we are see the about the resistance arc heating, so in that case, we are see the direct resistance heating as well as indirect resistance heating. So similarly, whenever we are just see the arc heating, so arc heating is having the same type, that is a direct arc heating as well as indirect arc heating. So simply in this type, that is a arc heating, so we are just see the first type, that is a direct arc furnace. And second one is the indirect arc furnace. Okay? So these are the two types. So this part will be covered in the next lecture. And this next lecture is having the time. Today we are conducting this next lecture from 2 to 3 p.m. I think. Okay? So if any doubts so, regarding this topic, you can just ask me. Yes. So all the students, please stay here for the 5 minutes. I will just put the attendance thing in the chat box. ठीक है, अगर जैसे कोई डाउट है तो आप पूछ सकते हो बेटा अभी. Yes, all the student attendance link will be floated in the chat box, so please all fill it. ठीक है, ओके. सो आई थिंक अवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर विल बी कंडक्टेड टू द सेम डेट ऑन द टाइम ऑफ 2 to 3 PM. ठीक है, सो वी आर जस्ट कवरिंग द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस आर्क फिटिंग, दैट इज डायरेक्ट आर्क फिटिंग फॉरनेस एज वेल एज इनडायरेक्ट आर्क फिटिंग फॉरनेस इनटू दिस लेक्चर. ठीक है, ओके, थैंक यू.